Hello again, Bear fans. We're here with the Rogue Double Dead Guy. I don't think I've actually ever reviewed the Dead Guy, but I certainly should have. It's the flagship brew of Rogue, and this is the higher alcohol content, at least, version of it. Dead Guy's a great little beer. Hopefully, this will be a great big beer. Man, it's not expecting that. It kind of overflew a little bit. Anyway, this has been sitting for a while, evidently. I got it at a bar today. I was in the mood to try something new, and you can see this is a 2009. I'm taping this in 2012, obviously. And so this is a three-year aged Double Dead Guy. And so it may not be representative of what you get when you try it. But let's see what we have here. This is 9%. I expect I will be wasted by the time I get through with this, because I've already had a little bit. And a beer. I've actually had quite a bit of drink tonight. Although I don't think I'm wasted yet, because it's been spread over a few hours. I've had a shit Pilsner from Rogue, so I've been kind of Rogue mood tonight, which was pretty good. This is from Chateau Rogue, and it wasn't probably as good as Sam Adams Noble Pils, but it was an excellent Pils for the style. And then I had a little bit of a Glenlivet 15 I'll review at some point. That was quite good. That was a few hours later. Then I moved on to a Schlitz, you know, like that. And then I had a cask Fuller's ESB, which is one of my favorite beers to have. If you can get out of a cask, you must try it. At the Leon County Pub is the only place in the area you can get it. And that's really exciting for me, is the pub hasn't had it in a long time. And so we've got it back. Nice head on this. Let me tilt this up for you. So you can see that nice head that is coming up on that. And this is going to last. Now, I'm generally cynical on aging, as you know. I think, for instance, with wine, I think everybody knows that more wine is drank too old than too young. The wine generally peaks at the oldest within a decade. And a lot of wine is consumed far after a decade. And most wines don't even peak that quickly. They peak most whites peak within months. And a lot of reds peak within a couple of years. And a few of the reds, like cabs, peak a few years later. And and similarly with whiskey, at some point, the whiskey becomes overaged. And probably you're paying way more than you should for the taste. You're paying more for the rarity of the whiskey than you are for the flavor of the whiskey, which doesn't make any sense to me. And I think aging beer is generally like that. The beer, for the most part, is pretty dang good at the start. And you're going to get different flavors. It's going to be smooth and meshed together. Different things are going to come out. But I don't know if it's necessarily better. I haven't heard anybody, even with the higher gravity beers, argue that a beer per se gets better. It just gets different. And it's almost a shame I don't have a new one to try with it. I should have thought to do that. Although, again, if I drank two of these at the same time, I would be so wasted by the end of it that it would be fun. That'd be almost comical. And I'll smell malts coming out pretty heavily in the smell of this. Very fruity, rather nice. Now the sip. delicious, really. Not the kind of hoppiness that you would expect from the Deck Guy. The Deck Guy's not an overly hoppy beer by any means, but I don't know what the IBUs on this are. Let me check if they have them. But the IBU is 72, and so this is a pretty hoppy beer. It's as hoppy as the Bell's Hop Slam that we reviewed earlier, but the by no measures do you feel that way. You feel even less hoppier than the Hop Slam. Instead, it's the other flavors that are dominating, possibly because of the age. The malts, kind of this almost fruity and apple-y flavor is kind of coming out. Not quite apple, really, but it's kind of got a fruit note. I can't place the fruit, but it's not apple as I try it again. A little citrus there from the hops, but everything's been kind of dulled down, very heavily balanced. Although I would expect, I mean, my memory of the Dead Guy, I've had the Double Dead Guy at actually the brew pub of Rogue and in Portland, and my memory of it was that it was excellent, but I don't remember exactly the flavors, and so this is, so I can't really describe it to you when it's younger, but this is a very balanced beer. While being very heavy. And so you've got this kind of citrus mixed with this kind of duller fruit note. And neither is really dominating. Quite nice, really. Quite nice. I think a little bit of that yeast is beginning to show itself. In the various kind of taste this is. Now I don't know how much this normally goes. Now I got this at a bar, so I almost certainly overpaid for it. Normally I think this goes well over double digits. And as to the question of whether it's worth it, almost certainly not. But it's a huge beer. And you can see this is a 22-ounce beer. This is one you can split among friends. And I always kind of like that. And probably best split among friends. Again, I'm going to get drunk as hell tonight. I'm probably going to drink this over a long period of time. Not going to get anywhere close to done this review. So it's a great one to split with friends. And kind of all enjoy kind of a nice little beer. Or a nice big beer. Because really this is a big beer. At this age, the flavors are not explosive. And I think that's one thing flavors do. I mean, aging does in beer. It kind of dulls everything. And smooths everything out. And meshes everything. And so nothing's as pronounced. And whether or not that's a good thing or not, I don't know. In some wines, it's a great thing. With beer, as I've always argued, you kind of want a more explosive flavor. But this is delicious and well worth trying. And if you haven't tried it, I would recommend it. And again, it might, if you can get it old and get it young, that might be a cool way to try it. I may try later. If I can find it again at this bar and younger in another place, to try it side by side with something a lot younger and see, kind of compare and contrast, see which is better. Regardless, it's general with Rogue's pale ales and stouts. Rogue, it's really specializes in pale ale and stouts. I wouldn't. And bitters, basically. Bitters and stouts. I wouldn't venture past that with Rogue. Rogue's one of those breweries. They do certain things well, but they do everything, and they don't do everything else well. Outside of the Shakespeare stout, I don't think you need to try anything else. Although the Pils was quite good. But anything within the pale ale range and all that is well worth trying. Anyway, that's all my time. See ya.